Dear listeners, tonight I invite you to journey with me into the heart of a mist-shrouded valley, a place where time stands still and legends come to life. Prepare to be transported to a realm of ancient magic and timeless courage as we uncover the saga of the Druid King's tomb. Settle in comfortably, close your eyes, and let the ethereal whispers of forgotten ages draw you into a tale of peril and wonder, where the bravery of two souls will decide the fate of a hidden world. The Tomb of the Druid King. In the heart of a distant land, where the tendrils of time seemed to lose their grip, lay a valley steeped in ancient mysteries. The very air here was thick with the whispers of the past, a heavy, almost tangible mist that clung to everything it touched. This was no ordinary fog. It swirled and danced with a life of its own, as if each droplet of moisture contained the spirits of those long departed. This veil of enigma cloaked the tomb of the Druid King, a figure of legend whose very name evoked awe and reverence. Once, long ago, the Druid King's magic had woven the fabric of the world, bending nature to his will and shaping destinies with his powerful incantations. His reign was a golden era, a time of prosperity and balance, until his death transformed his final resting place into a sanctuary of secrets and potent arcane energies. For centuries, the valley remained untouched, a place whispered about in the hushed tones of lore and superstition. It was said that those who dared to disturb the king's eternal slumber would unleash forces beyond mortal comprehension, forces that could rewrite the very laws of existence. On a day fated by the stars, a treasure hunter named Marcus decided to venture into this forgotten realm. Marcus was not a man easily swayed by fear or legend. His life was a tapestry of daring exploits, woven with threads of courage and a touch of recklessness. Tales of his escapades filled the taverns and marketplaces, where his name was spoken with a mix of admiration and incredulity. But even Marcus knew that this journey would be unlike any other. The promise of unimaginable riches, hidden away in the tomb of the Druid King, was a siren call he could not resist. Beside Marcus walked Elena, a scholar with an insatiable thirst for knowledge, especially of the arcane. Her life's work had been devoted to the study of druidic practices, ancient rituals, and the history of the forgotten king whose tomb they now sought. Elena's presence was a beacon of wisdom and caution, balancing Marcus's boldness with her meticulous understanding of the dangers they might face. She was not driven by the lure of treasure, but by the promise of uncovering artifacts and knowledge that could illuminate the mysteries of the past. As they made their way deeper into the valley, the fog seemed to grow denser, wrapping around them like a shroud. The further they ventured, the more palpable the air became with an eerie stillness. It was a silence so profound that it seemed to muffle their very thoughts, leaving only the sound of their cautious footsteps to echo through the void. Each step they took seemed to carry the weight of countless souls who had wandered these paths before, lost to the mists and the ages. The landscape around them was a desolate beauty, marked by twisted trees and ancient stones that stood like silent sentinels. The ground beneath their feet was soft and yielding, a dampness that spoke of centuries of undisturbed decay. Every now and then, the fog would part momentarily, revealing glimpses of a world long forgotten. The remnants of a forgotten civilization, overgrown and reclaimed by nature. These fleeting visions were like ghosts, ephemeral and haunting, hinting at the grandeur that once was. Marcus moved with a confidence born of experience, his eyes sharp and his senses heightened. He knew the value of caution, even as his heart raced with the thrill of the unknown. Elena, on the other hand, was absorbed in the atmosphere around her, her mind racing with the possibilities of what they might find. Her hands brushed against the ancient trees, feeling the textures of their bark, trying to commune with the past in a way only she could understand. Despite the legends and the palpable tension, there was a serenity to the valley, a sense that it was a place out of time, untouched by the world beyond its borders. This was a realm where the veil between the living and the dead was thin, where the past and present coexisted in a delicate balance. It was into this twilight world that Marcus and Elena stepped, each driven by their own desires, yet united in their quest. As the fog thickened around them, they could feel the eyes of the past watching them, judging their every move. It was as if the valley itself was alive, a sentient entity that knew the hearts and minds of those who dared to enter its domain. Marcus and Elena pressed on, undeterred by the unseen gaze, their determination unshaken. They knew that to turn back now would be to admit defeat, and neither was willing to concede to the shadows of legend. The valley held its breath as they ventured further, its secrets waiting to be unveiled. The tomb of the Druid King lay ahead, a beacon of mystery and power, calling to them through the fog. What awaited them within its ancient walls was a tale yet to be written, a story of courage, knowledge, and the timeless dance between light and darkness. From the very beginning, Marcus and Elena were met with challenges that tested their resolve and their courage. The foggy veil had been an eerie precursor, but nothing could have prepared them for the sheer force that awaited within the tomb itself. The moment they broke the ancient seal that guarded the entrance, a powerful wave of energy erupted from within, like a silent scream echoing through the ages. This energy was more than just a physical force. It was a call to all that lay dormant within the tomb, awakening ancient protections and dark curses that had been set in place to guard the resting place of the Druid King. As the stone door groaned open, releasing a rush of stale, cold air, the atmosphere around them seemed to shift. The temperature plummeted, and the dim light from their torches flickered as if struggling to maintain their grip on reality. Marcus and Elena exchanged a glance, both aware that they had crossed a threshold from which there was no return. With a deep breath, they stepped into the darkness of the tomb. The smell of old earth and forgotten enchantment filled the thick, heavy air inside. The walls were decorated with beautiful inscriptions and sculptures that recounted tales of the Druid King's rule and the potent spells that had been constructed to guard his last resting place. The deafening quiet was broken as they descended down into the catacombs by the faint sounds of whispering, which sounded like the rustle of leaves in a far-off forest. These were the ghosts of those who had formerly worked for the king, voices from the past that had awoken and realized who was intruding. Without warning, the first of the vengeful spirits appeared, materializing from the shadows with a wail that pierced the silence like a knife. These spectral guardians, bound by loyalty and duty, were relentless in their attacks, their ethereal forms flickering in and out of existence as they lunged at Marcus and Elena. Each strike was like a gust of freezing wind, sapping their strength and testing their will. Elena, with her extensive knowledge of druidic practices, fought to control the unleashed forces. She muttered incantations under her breath, her voice steady despite the chaos around her. Her hands moved with practiced precision, tracing symbols in the air as she attempted to calm the spirits and deactivate the traps that lined their path. But these were no ordinary spirits. They were imbued with the ancient magic of the Druid King himself, and their fury was formidable. Magical traps, hidden within the very stones of the catacombs, activated with each step they took. Arrows of pure energy shot from the walls. Flames erupted from the ground, and shadows seemed to come alive, twisting and writhing with malevolent intent. Marcus used his agility and combat skills to dodge and counter these threats, while Elena focused on neutralizing the enchantments. Together, they moved as a unit, their combined strengths pushing them forward through the labyrinth of danger. As they delved deeper, the true magnitude of their task became clear. It was not enough to merely survive the attacks. They had to find a way to reseal the tomb, to contain the powerful magic that threatened to spill into the world. The Druid King's power, if unleashed, could fall into the wrong hands and bring about untold destruction. This realization hung heavy over them, adding a sense of urgency to their every move. The catacombs seemed endless, a maze of twisting corridors and hidden chambers. Each turn brought new dangers, and each step was a test of their resolve. The spirits grew more numerous, their attacks more coordinated, as if sensing the determination of the intruders. Elena's druidic knowledge was stretched to its limits as she invoked ancient spells to pacify the spirits and disable the traps. Marcus, ever the protector, kept a vigilant watch, his every sense attuned to the threats around them. His bravery was unwavering, but even he could feel the weight of the tomb's defenses bearing down on them. The deeper they went, the more he realized that this was not a simple quest for treasure. It was a battle for survival against forces that defied comprehension. Elena's struggle was both physical and mental. The ancient magic she wielded required immense concentration and strength of will. She drew upon every ounce of her training and knowledge, her mind a whirlwind of symbols and incantations. The spirits responded to her efforts, some calming and retreating, while others resisted with a ferocity that spoke of deep, unyielding loyalty to their king. Despite the dangers that lay ahead, Marcus and Elena continued because they believed that their goal was more important than themselves. They understood that the real struggle lay not in only surviving, but in defending the world against the mayhem that would break out in the event that the Druid King's power got into the wrong hands. Their expedition through the tomb served as evidence of their bravery, tenacity, and unwavering spirit. As they ventured further into the heart of the catacombs, the air grew colder, the shadows darker, and the challenges more formidable. In the dim light of their torches, the walls of the catacombs seemed to stretch into infinity, an endless maze of shadow and stone. Each step Marcus and Elena took echoed with a hollow resonance, as if the very air around them held its breath. The journey thus far had tested their endurance and their wits, but the catacombs still held many secrets. It was during this exploration, when hope and determination hung in a delicate balance, that they stumbled upon a hidden passage, an unexpected doorway concealed behind a veil of illusionary magic. The entrance to the passage was subtle, almost imperceptible to the untrained eye. It was Elena's keen sense for magical anomalies that led them to it. She paused, her fingers tracing the faint outline of runes etched into the stone. Whispering an incantation, she felt the air shimmer and shift, revealing the hidden door. With a gentle push, it swung open silently, inviting them into the unknown. The passage was narrow and winding, its walls lined with ancient carvings that seemed to tell a story in a language long forgotten. The air here was different, carrying a sense of anticipation and an undercurrent of power. As they ventured deeper, the temperature dropped, and a strange luminescence began to emanate from the walls, casting an eerie glow that illuminated their path. At the end of the passage, they found a chamber, hidden from the world for centuries. It was a sanctuary, untouched by time, and shielded from the chaos outside. The chamber was adorned with symbols of the Druidic order, and at its center stood a pedestal upon which lay an ancient manuscript, bound in weathered leather, and inscribed with symbols that seemed to pulse with a life of their own. Elena approached the manuscript with reverence, her heart pounding in her chest. As she opened it, the pages crackled softly, releasing a faint scent of aged parchment and lingering magic. The manuscript was written by the Druid King himself, a testament to his wisdom and foresight. It contained detailed instructions on how to reseal the tomb, a complex ritual designed to bind the powerful forces within and protect the world from their potential wrath. But as they read further, they discovered more than just a guide. The manuscript held a dire warning. If the ritual was not performed correctly, an unknown power, more dangerous than anything they had encountered, would be unleashed. This power, hinted at in cryptic verses, seemed to be a force of pure chaos, capable of bending reality and wreaking havoc upon the world. Elena's eyes widened as she deciphered the ancient symbols and incantations. The manuscript was not just a set of instructions. It was a test, a measure of worthiness for those who dared to undertake the ritual. The Druid King had foreseen the possibility of his tomb being disturbed, and had crafted this test to ensure that only those pure of heart and strong of will could reseal the tomb. As they studied the manuscript, the hidden story of the Druid King began to unfold. Through the intricate symbols and poetic incantations, a tale of treachery and betrayal emerged. The king, once revered and beloved, had been the victim of a conspiracy, orchestrated by those who coveted his power. His closest advisors, driven by greed and ambition, had turned against him, leading to his untimely death. The Druid King's final act of defiance was to hide away a treasure of boundless power, a treasure that could only be revealed to those who proved themselves worthy through the completion of the ritual. This treasure, hinted at but never explicitly described, was said to hold the key to unimaginable magical abilities, capable of altering the very fabric of existence. Marcus and Elena realized the gravity of their discovery. They were not just treasure hunters or scholars on a quest. They were now the stewards of an ancient legacy, entrusted with a task that held the fate of the world in its balance. The responsibility weighed heavily upon them, but it also steeled their resolve. They knew that to fail would be to unleash untold horrors, but to succeed would be to preserve a power that could change the course of history. The hidden chamber, with its ancient manuscript and the revelations it held, became a turning point in their journey. It was no longer just about survival or the pursuit of knowledge. It was about proving their worth and fulfilling a destiny that had been written long before their time. The chamber's serene atmosphere belied the immense significance of what they had found, and as they prepared to leave, they felt a sense of purpose and determination like never before. With the manuscript in hand, they retraced their steps through the narrow passage, their minds racing with the knowledge they had gained and the challenges that lay ahead. The catacombs, once a place of darkness and danger, now seemed to pulse with a renewed energy, as if the very stones themselves acknowledged the importance of their quest. Marcus and Elena emerged from the hidden passage, ready to face whatever trials awaited. Armed with the wisdom of the Druid King and a newfound understanding of the true nature of their mission. The shadows of the catacombs stretched long and menacing as Marcus and Elena pressed onward. Time seemed to slip through their fingers like sand, and with every passing moment, the dangers they faced grew ever more formidable. Yet, the gravity of their mission bound them together, their combined resolve as unyielding as the ancient stone around them. Through twisting corridors and past traps, both magical and mechanical, they navigated with a sense of urgency that heightened their senses. Each obstacle they overcame, whether it was a spectral guardian or a hidden pitfall, honed their teamwork and sharpened their focus. The stakes were clear. To fail would be to unleash untold chaos, a responsibility neither of them took lightly. At last, after what felt like an eternity of struggle, they arrived at the heart of the tomb, the central chamber where the Druid King's sarcophagus lay. This monumental room was vast, its high ceiling lost in shadow, its walls inscribed with the history and legacy of the Druid King. The air here was thick with magic, a palpable energy that thrummed like a heartbeat, filling the chamber with a sense of awe and reverence. Elena, clutching the ancient manuscript, stepped forward with a determined expression. She could feel the power radiating from the sarcophagus, a testament to the might of the Druid King, even in death. With a deep breath, she began the ritual to reseal the tomb, her voice steady as she chanted the incantations inscribed in the manuscript. Each word resonated with the magic that had been woven into the very fabric of the tomb, invoking the ancient protections meant to guard this sacred place. As Elena concentrated on the ritual, Marcus's attention was drawn to a glint of light from the corner of the chamber. Curiosity and the lure of discovery led him to a small, hidden doorway, cleverly concealed behind an ornate tapestry. Pushing it open, he found himself in a smaller chamber, filled with artifacts that sparkled with an otherworldly glow. This was the Druid King's treasure, a collection of items imbued with immense power. The allure of the artifacts was overwhelming, each one calling to Marcus with promises of wealth and power. Unable to resist, he stepped inside, triggering a series of ancient mechanisms. The ground beneath him shuddered, and a deep rumble echoed through the tomb as the chambers began to collapse. In the main chamber, Elena's chant faltered as the ground shook violently. A spectral figure materialized before her, the ghostly visage of the Druid King himself. His eyes, filled with an ethereal fire, bore into Marcus, who stood frozen in the treasure room. The king's voice, though a mere whisper of its former power, was laced with stern rebuke. "Greed has no place here," the Druid King intoned, his words reverberating through the chamber. "Only those pure of heart can wield the power contained within these walls." Realizing the gravity of the situation, Elena returned to the manuscript, her mind racing to complete the ritual. She understood that the Druid King's power was not meant for just anyone. It required a heart unclouded by selfish desires. Summoning all her strength, she invoked the final incantations, calling upon the ultimate protection written in the manuscript. Light began to fill the room, emanating from the sarcophagus and spreading outward like the dawn breaking over a dark horizon. The spirits, once restless and vengeful, retreated before the purity of the light, their anger pacified. The collapsing chambers ceased their violent tremors, and the ancient mechanisms ground to a halt. The magical energy coalesced around the sarcophagus, resealing the tomb with a barrier of light that shimmered with protective enchantments. The treasure room, too, was enveloped in this protective aura, safeguarding the artifacts from those unworthy to claim them. As the light subsided, Marcus found himself freed from the intoxicating allure of the artifacts. Clarity returned to his mind, and with it, a deep sense of shame for his momentary lapse. Elena's eyes met his, and in that shared glance, there was an unspoken understanding of the immense responsibility they now bore. They had been tested, and, through perseverance and a bit of fortune, had succeeded. Marcus vowed to keep the location of the tomb and its treasures a closely guarded secret, recognizing the dangers that such power could pose if it fell into the wrong hands. Together, they made their way out of the tomb, emerging once more into the fog-covered valley. The oppressive silence had lifted, replaced by a tranquil stillness that spoke of peace restored. As they walked away from the tomb, the weight of their journey settled upon them, but so too did a sense of fulfillment. They had not only survived, but had safeguarded a power that could have wrought great destruction. Their story, bound by the trials they had faced and the wisdom they had gained, would become a legend, a warning to all who might seek to disturb the peace of the Druid King. In the fog-covered valley, the tomb remained protected, its boundless power hidden away for eternity, a testament to the enduring legacy of the Druid King and the bravery of those who had honored his final rest. And that, dear listeners, was the tale of the Druid King's tomb. Marcus and Elena, through their courage and determination, have not only safeguarded ancient magic, but also preserved the delicate balance between light and darkness. Their journey through the misty veil and treacherous catacombs reminds us that true bravery lies in selflessness and wisdom. So remember, behind every mystery lies a story waiting to be uncovered, and in every heart, the potential for heroism. If you enjoyed tonight's mystical adventure, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss a tale of enchantment and wonder. What would you do if you were in Marcus's shoes? Would you resist the allure of power or embrace it? Let us know in the comments below. Until next time, may you have sweet dreams and magical adventures every night.